When you get out in that day, like that from one year, how tough is it to lose a game like that when you had a couple of opportunities?
Well, whether you get an outing from Bull Needle like that or not, it's tough to lose that type of game. Comet said to me in the ninth by my director of baseball operations, Chad Zerker, was a great comment. He says, you know, we've made some really good pitchers in this league work, but we don't make them pay. And that hurts. That hurts a little bit. Will Neely matched, kudos to him. I mean, gosh darn, he went seven innings, 93 pitches. It was the most pitches he had thrown this year. And I thought, you've heard me say a long time, when I smell victory, I'm going to go give it to the guys that should take us to it. And unfortunately, it didn't work out tonight.
You said last week a lot of the freshmen haven't really developed a whole lot. Will seems to be a guy that has done a lot of development. What have you seen this past month?
Will's really stepped up. And, the thing I've recognized is Will is a lot more comfortable in the starting as a starter. In high school, I'm sure he came out of the bullpen. I just don't think he was totally settled in at times. But I think he's continued to give us three outings in a row that he hasn't pitched. He's given us a chance, and that's what we ask. And, early on we had some opportunities, and we just didn't, Vincent comes up with bases loaded, hits that sinking line drive in the right, and just a bad decision on the bases by Benito that we teach that you go back no matter what. And he did it was a bad decision and it ended up costing us.
Did he just kind of freeze there? Have you got a chance?
He extended off, and I asked him in the dugout. He says, "Coach, I saw it going down." Well, in that situation, it doesn't matter. You could almost crawl home, and first reaction should be back, and aim back to the bag. And if the guy makes a great catch like the young man did, then we're still tagging and we score. And I'll tell you that on the back end of that play, the situation with Nick at first, in my opinion, was not good for us. I saw it very clearly. Nick got back. Saw it on replay. Nick got back. It hurt us because the next guy ended up walking. And in this league, those kind of things are gonna hurt you a little bit, a lot.
I guess another play at first. Did you think Jordan beat it out?
No, I thought he got that one right. To be honest with you, and that one I thought he got right. I thought he got him by a step. And then the first thing that went to my mind is Jordan has a little bit of a tweaked hamstring. That's the first thing that went to my mind is that step may have cost us a little bit, but he was giving us everything he could.
To go back to Will a little bit, just what has been working for him, basically, what's allowed him to settle in?
Well, tonight I really thought his fastball command was a lot better. His changeup's his best pitch, and I thought he really kept them off balance with that. But the difference is because he was able to establish his fastball. I thought he made one mistake throughout the whole game, and that was to the 9-hole hitter after we were up 1-0, and he made him pay by hitting it out. But when you throw 93 pitches and I feel you make one mistake, it shouldn't cost you like it did tonight.
You mentioned just, going to your guys in that case. I mean, what did you kind of think about Andy's outing in general? Obviously, he gives it the run, but was there?
Well, you can't go 3-2 and hit the first guy. He came out and you could tell he had some energy in him, and his warm-up pitches weren't very good, and then he settled in a little bit, and we go 1-1, and the slider that he spiked in the dirt and hitting Tyler in the ear and hurt him a little bit, and then we go 3-2, and then we're just trying to center up a fastball, and we hit him. And, in this game of baseball, free passes usually come back to haunt you. And he was able to get two outs. And then I thought Robertson did a good job of a good piece of hitting to stay on that slider, and they hit it through the four hole.
So you were able to get Lang to work a lot. What were you guys doing at the plate to kind of get to him a little bit? Obviously, didn't make him pay.
But. Well, I don't know if it was what we were doing. I think it was what he was doing. I don't think he came out real sharp. But see, really good pitchers, when you get that opportunity, you've got to knock them down. And we didn't do that. And then he started settling in, and that's what good pitchers do. He started getting into the rhythm, and we knew going into this game, he's one of the best in this league, or let alone the country. And he settled in, and he did what a good Friday night guy does. And then he took him into the eighth inning, and then they have the lead, and they give it off to their closer.
What did he just do well when he got into a rhythm, basically?
You know, I thought he really, the curveball's really good. Yeah. The curveball's really good. He snuck in a couple changeups that got a couple guys on early swings. But the curveball is pretty dominant. He was able to start establishing it early in the game. He wasn't settled in with his curveball, and his fastball was all over the place. I looked up at the scoreboard at the end of the first, and we had bases loaded, nobody out, and then they get out of it. We didn't have a hit in that inning, so it was a time that we we had a chance to get something with what they were giving us. We give them something late, and they take advantage of it, and that's the difference.
Is this one of the games that you kind of look at and say, man, this is sort of what our season's been like? When something's going well, it seems like something else doesn't.
I tell you, going into this weekend, I still have a good feeling. And I still feel confident we're going to win this series. We've got to do something, though. We've got to do something, and I keep stressing that to our players. We can't expect good teams in this conference to give us something. And we've got to do something when it counts. And kind of like when I go back to the early part of the year, it wasn't SEC play, but we were talking a lot about guys coming through in the clutch, and we haven't had that lately. And it becomes a mindset. I think it becomes a little tighter because we know that lately we haven't been able to do that. We've got to get out of it. I keep telling them we have nothing to lose. Let it go. Whatever you've been doing lately, just make a change because it hasn't worked lately. So we get another opportunity tomorrow. We're going to have to I'm sure they'll let it go away from them sooner than I'll get let it go away from me. I think you're right. Tonight was kind of an example of what we've had to go through a lot.
All right, yes, sir. Thank you.